U.S. government was behind the attacks.
Jet fuel is four-fifths kerosene, which is not a hot burning fuel. And they want us to believe that it melted these steel structured girders and caused these buildings to pancake, collapse to the ground. I was on the site within 2 weeks after it happened, and I saw none of these pancakes. Wouldn't they all be piled up in a huge mass on the ground? And yet everything was blown into dust. My wife's parents are still alive, and they're elderly people. And when I try to bring this up with them, they don't want to believe it. And the reason is so simple. They don't believe anyone can be that evil. And I think a great deal of people in this country are of that same thought.
Hey, how are you?
Fine, I'm Josh Havia.
Otto, what do you think about the comics suggesting that show on 9/11? Coming out saying that the buildings are imploded.
Your stepfather was an SS officer. You said in your book you loved Hitler. You did. It's a comment. Arnold, you still got your Nazi belt on? You got the SS belt on? We know that you're a Nazi and it's not going to be hidden. We know that, sir. You will never get a new world order. Arnold, we know that you're a Nazi.
Can you please tell the 9/11 victims what happened in the bunker? A lot of 9/11 victims have unanswered questions into what happened in that bunker.
You know, it's really nice to get to talk about something besides politics.
All right.
Okay, thank you very, very much.
There is a 911 illness. It's a respiratory illness. It's killed many, many people. There are families without parents, not of whom were taken down by terrorists or the plane, but who were sort of let down by our government. So first responders, this should be an act of Congress immediately, and they should all be getting the best treatment that is available in this nation while we still have the semblance of democracy.
President Bush is a lying criminal, member of Skull and Bones, and the Bohemian Grove, where they do mock human sacrifices every year.
He's also the president of the United States of America, you disrespectful little cock.
Danny Bonaducci joins me now. Danny, thanks for coming on, and thanks for telling that little bleep to where he could shove it, bleep.
But I'm not particularly politically inclined. This guy and his nut job followers made me a political person overnight, and I didn't ask for the job. This little tape on YouTube took on a life of its own.
Kids like you will change the world when they believe what they believe and they're not afraid to say it. And with that little video camera, that's the new way that America is going to be equalized. So keep doing it.
There was a lot of questions about it. My son Charlie introduced me to a lot of information, questions, and so forth. And up until then, which was just like last year, I was very dubious.
Sure.
But I did not want to believe that my government could possibly be involved in such a thing.
Absolutely, I don't think any of us want to.
I couldn't live in a country that I thought could do that.
Exactly.
That would be the ultimate betrayal.
Sure.
Then, however, there's been so many revelations that now I have my doubts. And chief among them is the Building 7. How did they break that building so that it came down on the evening of the day?
Are you afraid to do it? The Larry Silverstein statement, to pull it, and the
pull it.
Way that it all came down? Absolutely.
How convenient.
Yes.
When did they rig that building?
Would you support a new investigation on 9/11?
You know, that's like, you know, that they don't investigate themselves in this country. Those people, there would be a whitewash. It would be like the Kennedy thing. It would be like everything.
Okay.
The people who are in charge do what they want, and they will always do what they want. The power does what it wants to. And I wouldn't trust an investigation. It's just fun. It's good speculation.
Those who give up liberty for security
deserve neither liberty nor security. Your Constitution, America, is being stripped away from you by domestic enemies while they send our troops to third world countries. Our country has been overrun by people that want to destroy America. I got videos. I got websites. I can show you that your government funded Al-Qaeda. Admitted that there were explosives in Building 7, thermite, military-grade explosives. How to get in there?
There's this group, Beit Shalom, who is walking across the country from the West Coast all the way to Washington, D.C. All they're doing is calling an end to this war and calling for 9/11 truth, and they're being harassed everywhere they go.
What can I do for you?
Huh?
What can I do for you?
I just need, have you got an ID or anything? Turn the camera off.
No, sir.
Turn the camera off.
No, sir.
You want to go to jail?
Sir, I've been through this already with the...
Then I need an ID or something.
You have no reason to ID me. But do you understand why you shouldn't stop and just randomly ask for people's ID? This is America, bro.
I got walking. You shut that off. I don't want that. Get that away from my face, sir.
I'm not going to shut it off.
You got any ID on you?
I don't.
Turn the camera away.
No. No, sir. Huh? You're a public officer.
Yes, I am.
So I have the right to... videotape you. Okay.
All I'm wanting is an ID.
I can't do that unless you have a lawful reason to ask me.
What's up?
What's up?
You can just turn that off.
Why?
Because I asked you to.
There's no law against it.
Just turn it off.
I'll put it down here.
But turn it off.
Sir, we're not gonna,
I asked you to turn it off.
I'm not going
to
turn it off.
Sir,
you're
not,
a public officer.
You're a public officer on the public street.
Okay, let's go on down the road then. What's the deal?
Going down the road where?
I just asked you not to do that, okay? I don't want a picture taken.
Well, sir, you're a public officer.
That's fine. You bet.
Please don't touch our camera.
Now talk to me.
Please don't touch our camera, sir. Please don't do that.
You guys are going to have to cooperate with me.
Well, we're cooperating.
There's nothing wrong with filming.
Turn that off.
Sir, we're not going to turn it off.
What's your name?
I don't feel I have to give it to you if I haven't done anything wrong.
Well, I'm asking you for your name. I'm not fooling with you. Have you got anything on you?
No, sir.
I'm going to take you to the next county because I don't want you in this county.
You can't do that. You're breaking.
Because I have a right to protect you.
You're breaking the law.
There's a statue that we're breaking. We'd be happy to turn it off.
Is there a specific reason, sir?
Here.
I don't feel comfortable with that. I haven't broken any laws.
Okay.
I'm not causing a disturbance.
I'm just going to ask you guys just to go on down the road, okay?
Are you saying we have no right to be here?
I'm just telling you to go on down the road.
What do you mean by that?
Okay. You just go on down, get out of city limits. Do
you asking
you want.
Us to leave town?
I'm just telling you to go on down the road.
Do you know that we have a constitutional right to do this?
An officer of the law asks you for your name, you're supposed to provide that to them. Okay?
Not if I haven't done anything wrong, sir.
Where are you headed?
I'm going to Washington, D.C.
Okay. Carry on.
I'm waiting to leave a message.
Let's get off the phone. It's no big deal. So you're making a big deal out
of
it.
I want him to know what's going on so he can contact our people.
Okay.
Elliot, it's me. I'm being unlawfully detained by Cumberland County Sheriff's Department. Call the media, call our contacts, get them here immediately. Get to the car. Cumberland County, it's Sheriff Wiki, W-I-C-K-E.
Thank you.
This is not Nazi Germany. This is not Communist Russia. This is United States of
get
America.
Get your stuff and get down the road. If you step on that road, I'll arrest you.
If I give you a documentary about 9/11, will you watch it? Think it was an inside job?
Probably not.
What if it was? Would that concern you as a police officer?
Oh, yeah.
If I give you my card, will you watch a documentary on our website about 9/11 that we made?
Oh, there's a possibility. When's it not going to be on?
Oh, it's on there right now. You can watch it for free. Every day we get stopped. Every day we get ID'd. You can't go anywhere in America anymore without your papers.
Why?
Death Breeze, Kid Carson County. You guys got ID on you?
What is
you
that?
Yes, I am.
Okay. We just got stopped by a sheriff.
Oh, yeah?
Not sure. We have him on.